Why do I have high LDL cholesterol when my diet is on point? Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
Deanna's fourth and final question is the last question of the AMA for today. Total cholesterol high because of high levels of LDL. Why I have a high level of LDL when my diet seems to be on point with a lot of vegetables, a good protein source of fish, mostly salmon, white chicken, and healthy fats daily with avocado and coconut oil and MCT oil. I also practice time-restricted feeding 24 and 18-6 and exercise regularly. My triglycerides seem to be okay. And HDL usually in optimal zone between 34 to 79. But I cannot figure out the LDL issue. What should I look into? How to correct it? Do you know if large consumption of coconut oil could lead to a high LDL? So coconut oil will probably raise LDL, just raises HDL more. Coconut oil is generally good for the ratio, but it will increase the total cholesterol and it will increase the absolute level of LDL cholesterol. I think generally in the presence of insulin sensitivity, more carbohydrate, less fat will lower LDL. But in the presence of insulin resistance, more carbohydrate will sometimes raise LDL. And so I think look at insulin sensitivity and body composition, normalizing those first. If those are on point, then possibly substituting carbohydrate for fat will help with the LDL. Certainly the reducing the coconut oil will probably help. And then I would also think about how high it is. So I do think that the reference range is a little bit too restricted in the context of good diets and healthy metabolism. And so if it's a little bit out of the reference range and the total is under 250 for, I forgot your age, but I would say 250 for a woman of menopausal age. And for a younger woman, I would say like 220. And if the LDL is only a little bit out of the range and the HDL is good, I wouldn't worry too much about it. If the total to HDL cholesterol ratio is under 4, especially if it's close to 3.0 or underneath that, then I wouldn't be worrying about LDL that's a little bit out of the range. But I would look at coconut oil, reducing it, body composition, normalizing it, insulin sensitivity, optimizing it. And if all those things are done, substituting some more carbohydrate, less fat may help if you think it's needed.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. For the remainder of 2020, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.